News, and I'm Shirley Brown. Thank you for joining us this morning. Today is Youth Day 2015, and it's being held at Pleasant Grove Missionary Baptist Church, located in Fairfield, Alabama, where Dr. Willie Wells Jr. is pastor. The youth at the Grove have an awesome opportunity to express their love for God by singing, dancing, stepping, and miming. This event is held every year in hopes to allow others, young and mature, to know who God is and potentially give their life over to Him. The youth are not only the church of tomorrow, but today as well, and I know they will do an exceptional job. Now, moving on to a more somber note, there has been some troubling incidents happening in Charleston, South Carolina recently. On the eve of June 17, 2015, a mass shooting took place at Emmanuel AME Church. The congregation is one of the United States' oldest black churches and has long been a site for community organization around civil rights. 9 people lost their lives, including the senior pastor and a state senator. Police apprehended a suspect the morning after the attack and are now still investigating whether the shooting was a hate crime or an act of domestic terrorism. Some members displayed exactly how we, as Christians, should act. Instead of reverting back with anger, members chose to pray. So let's continue to pray not only for ourselves, but for others as well. On to our next story. About a month ago, there were several reported fires at predominantly black churches in North Carolina, South Carolina, Florida, and Tennessee, which some have been attributed to potential fallouts from the recent South Carolina church shooting. Federal investigators are looking into some of the cases to determine whether hate crimes were the cause, but so far, the fires do not appear to be related. You know, although these horrible things have happened, we have to remember, God is still in control. We may not know why all these things have occurred, and it's okay to be confused, but continue to trust and obey, not only in the good times, but also in the bad as well. Get to know Him for yourself, today and not tomorrow. This ends another broadcast. I'm Shirley Brown with PGMBC News, signing off.
It's that time of the year again where we get to express our love for God. He's been so good to us that words sometimes are not enough. As youth, we could be doing a lot of different things, but because God has revealed Himself in our lives, we have been set free from the bondage of sin. The Grove is one of the best churches in Fairfield, not only because of the powerful preaching, but because we can get involved in different things that are fun and still learn about God's will and purpose for our lives. The Grove's theme is simple, but it's a powerful. It is to be Christ-centered.
Christ-centered.
We keep Christ in the center of our lives. We want to let everyone know He lives within us.
It's also to love God.
Love God.
You can't be saved unless you love God, and we love God.
We are to love people.
Love people.
We love each and everyone, no matter how different from us they may be. We love people because God loves us.
We also share Jesus.
Share Jesus.
Through cultural arts such as singing, dancing, stepping, and miming, we get to share how great Jesus is in our lives in many different ways.
And lastly, we strive to make disciples.
Make disciples.
Our goal is to save a life so that they can tell others about Jesus and make even more disciples. We want everyone to know Christians can have fun too.
Dear God, We love, we praise your holy name. We ask that you bless our church and bless us as we demonstrate what you truly mean to us. Give us the confidence to carry out your will. And we pray that through what we're about to do, that someone may want to get to know you for themselves. Let not our will, but your will be done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, it's showtime.
It would have been me.